ಸಂತ ದುಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸಂತ ದುಡ್ತೀನಿ ಹಂಗಾಗ್ಲಿ ಯಾಕೆ
Okay, good morning students.
Good morning.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, screen is visible?
Yes, yes, sir.
Let's start with the next topic. As already we have discussed in the last class, we are discussing about switching. Under switching, already we have studied two types, that is circuit switch network we have finished, and then under packet switch we have completed datagram switching. In packet switching, it is all about finding a dedicated path between sender and receiver. In datagram packet, always there will be a dedicated path between sender and receiver. So that is what we have seen in case of circuit switched network. So here the dedicated path will be established. Here the pink line shows this dedicated path will be established, and there will be a very less delay with respect to this because packets will get transmit immediately. The problem of this is the resources will be underutilized. That is nothing but once you allocate a resources to this, until and unless it completes the transmission, it will not release those resources. So that is one drawback, but delay is very less with respect to this. The main advantage of circuit switched is it is mainly used in telephonic conversation, that is nothing but voice applications. So that is the use of circuit switched. The main working is dedicated path will be established first, and then data transfer will be done, and then data termination will happen. It works in three ways, that is the setup, and then data transfer, then closure. Then we have discussed delay, that is very less delay will be there because no, it will not wait in any of the switches as it is having separate path only. Then we have discussed datagram network. Here it is mainly used for the packet transmission, not for the voice transmission. So our messages will be divided into multiple packets, and each packet will be traveling randomly in the among the switches, and each switch will be having, it is going to identify the address from the packet header. Packet header will be having an address of the next switches. So this switch will find out the address of the next switches, and it will forward randomly. Some switches, some packets will take some this route, some will take this route, some will take this route. It is going to be a random process. Here there is no dedicated path, so delay is going to be more. For example, if it is sending like this, if this switch is not free, then these packets has to wait. So that is the one drawback of this, because here delay will be more. And the second drawback of this is the packets will not be received in order because each are taking independent path. So we don't know which will come first and which will come last. They will not come in the order in which we are sent. They will come in order in which they receive. So later we have to do the sorting of that. Another problem here we need to identify is this switch knows the address of next switches, but exactly this switch don't know the who is the destination. So this problem will be addressed in our next coming one, that is virtual circuit switch, because actually the A intention is to send the data to the X, but actually this switch will not be having an information what is the X address. So it will be having an address of the next switches itself. So we don't know who will be how the data has to be sent, but randomly it will be forwarding to the next switches, and those switches randomly they will be forwarding to the next, and finally somehow they will reach the destination. So that is how. And next we have used one more table in the previous one, that is routing table, destination address of the next switch, and then in which port it is going out. Already I said it is for identifying the next switch. So this is all about, we have this here, the delay will be more because when it comes here it has to take the decision on which switch I have to send next, as well as if it is not free, sometime they will wait for the decision and all. So some kind of delay will be there at the each switch. So delay is going to be more with respect to the packet switch network. So this is all we have discussed in the, this is a quick recap of the last class, because I need that for the virtual circuit network also. Is it clear? Previous class content, whatever we have discussed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then let's start with the next very important topic, that is virtual circuit network. It is a most important question for your exam also. So virtual circuit network is a cross between a circuit switch network and a datagram network. It has some characteristics of both. That is nothing but whatever the advantages we had in circuit switched and whatever the advantages we had in datagram, both will be merged and it will be formed. That is nothing but some characteristics I will take from circuit switched and some characteristics will be taken from datagram. The first advantage is it is having a less delay. So across, what is that? Circuit switch is having very less delay because it is going to have a dedicated path. So even virtual circuit network is going to have a dedicated path, because the first problem is it is going to have a dedicated path. That is why very less delay will be there. So that is the advantage of that. So that will be taken from second one. From second one, what is the advantage? Here delay will be reduced, delay will be increased, but packets will be transmitting randomly, but resources will be used more efficiently, because resources will not be allocated in advance. Resources will be allocated dynamically whenever they request. So that another advantage of the second one also will be taken. So both characteristics will be merged and the virtual circuit will be formed. So that is why cross between circuit switch network and datagram network. So here we have to discuss addressing. Then it also works in a three phases, just like your circuit switch, because the three switch phases are nothing but first one is a setup phase, second one is a transfer phase, data transfer, third one is a termination, and how efficient it is and what is the delay, that we have to discuss here. So coming to the one example, this is a once virtual circuit network, the sample example. Make sure whatever the example in future we discuss, the same diagram will be made use, and end system. These are all the A, B, C, D are the end system, and these are all the intermediate switches through that we are going to send the data. Now assume that we are going to send the data from A to B. So source will be A and destination will be B. As of now, you understand this much. We'll go to the next. So in this virtual circuit networks, one thing we are going to use, that is virtual circuit identifier. So clearly you understand what do you mean by virtual circuit identifier. Each and every switch which we are using is going to have some kind of table, that is already we know it is going to have a routing table. See here, this is the one switch, sample switch we have taken. Then as usual, we know our messages will be divided into packets. So one packet is here, the sample packet is here, sample packet followed by one number is given here, that is called as virtual circuit identifier. That means this link identifier, it is whatever the link is coming to this switch, this link we call it as input link to this switch. So this link will be identified by a number called as 14. So that number we call it as a virtual circuit identifier. So when it receives this data packet at this particular switch on particular port, then it has to send that data to the another link, that is called as outgoing link. Even outgoing link is going to have some kind of number, that is called as virtual circuit identifier. So this virtual circuit identifier is 14, but for this the virtual circuit identifier is 77. So this is how each and every switch will be having input VCI as well as output VCI. Is it clear why VCI has to be used? To identify this link, one number is going to be used. So that is called as virtual circuit identifier.
This is mainly used to check whether this link is free or not. Whether this link is free or not. So this 77 number indicates this link is represented by a number 77. Later, if the 77 link is free, then I will transmit the data. So that is how the VCI are used. Each and every switch will be having this input VCI as well as output VCI. But how these numbers will be obtained, that is again story is there. We'll go for that later. But as of now, I have taken some sample numbers. That is, this is a 14 is an incoming VCI and 77 is an outgoing VCI for this particular switch. So like this, all switches will be having incoming VCI, outgoing VCI, incoming VCI, outgoing. Like this, it will be there for all the switches. So then coming to the switch and table, how this actually works. Oh, well, with the help of only one switch, we'll see. With the help of only one switch, we'll see first how the actual transmission of data will happen. This is for the sample. Now assume that two packets are coming on a two different links, because already I said our link will be divided into multiple channels. So this 77 indicates it is coming on 177th channel and this is coming on another 14th channel. Means this is a VCI, virtual circuit identifiers. So there are multiple virtual circuit identifier. Two packets are coming to this particular port. On which port they are coming? This switch is having three ports. Means one port is an incoming port. No, it is going, this one indicates it is going to be a port one. So on port one, VCI 14 is going to come. Then on a first port itself, another packet is coming with a VCI 77. Both are coming. Then what this switch is doing, this is an incoming table, then outgoing table. So what this switch will do, on third port, it will send a VCI, it will send the this particular packet which had a 14. So whatever the VCI 14, it was there earlier, that has been sent on the third port, but no VCI will get changed because again the identifier for this link is going to be different. So that is virtual circuit identifier is different for this. But whatever the data we have received at the port 1 with the VCI 14, has been transferred at a port 3, that is on the link or identifier 22. Then whatever the data we have received with the VCI 77 on a port 1 will be sent at a port 2 with a VCI 41. That means on that particular identifier link it has been sent. See here, data 22 it has been sent here, data 41 it has been sent here. That means the one with which has come with the 77 is sent here, one which had come with a 14 has been sent here. That is, decision will be taken by switch itself. But make sure in this, from this diagram, you need to understand each and every incoming packet will be having a VCI and each and every outgoing packet also will be having a different VCI. So this VCI is going to be different and this VCI is going to be different because it depends on the number of links available. So whatever the link we are using, based on that, this number is going to get vary. But the same VCI will not be carried from incoming to outgoing. Don't get confused. So that is how the data will get transmit. We'll see in detail here. So this is actual, according to the diagram I said here, A is going to send the data to the B. How it will send? So directly I'm telling you the how data will be transmitted. Already path is set up, but how this path is set up, that we'll see later. But assume that in circuit switch network, there will be a dedicated path as we already discussed. First, the path will be established and then the data transfer will be done and then the termination will be done. Here, first step I have skipped intentionally so that I will tell you that later. First step is all about establishing a path. So he has established the path already. That means A will send it to this switch first and then this will send it to this second switch and then this will be the fourth switch and then here, finally, it will reach the destination. Already path has been established. How this path has been established, we'll see later. No, you don't worry about the path, how it has got established. Only thing you need to understand how data is getting transmitted. So this is all about to understand the data transmission. Already I am in the second step. First step I have skipped. So let us assume that we are sending a packet called as data, which is having an incoming VCI 14. And on which port we are receiving this? On first port, just enter here on first port, VCI 14 we are receiving. Then what decision this is taking, this particular switch, it is sending that packet on a third port on a VCI 66. Then data is getting converted, data followed by the new VCI, that is 66. Then it will come here. On which port it is coming here? It is coming on the port one of this particular switch. and then the VCI of this incoming is 66. Then what this switch is taking the decision? It is sending that at the port 2 and it is making its entry of a VCI as 22. Then again it will come here, then it is coming at the port 2 and VCI is 22. Then it will send it at the third port with a VCI 77. So this is how the data will actually get transferred from source to the destination. But this path is already established. So that is the main thing to understand how it has got established. Once we get a VCI number, data transmission is going to be very easy. But how to get that VCI number is a question. But how data get transmit, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we'll see how the setup will happen. No, I am coming back to the first step. So how VCI numbers we will get it. So just try to understand how the setup, that is already I said, dedicated path will be established first and then the data transmission and then the termination. No, we are in the first step. Already second step we have seen how it will be done once we get the VCI numbers. Now assume that the frame will be sent. So in this mainly it is to set up a request in a virtual circuit network. No, we have to set up a path using this. So how that path will be set? First A will send a request. Request frame we call this. It is not the data frame. It is the request frame. It is only to establish the path it is sending a request. It is not a data what we are sending. This is the first step. Here the A will send a request phase that I want to send a data to the particular person called as B. Then that request phase also will be on which link it is coming, on some link it is coming. So this link will be having some VCI number. So that incoming VCI number is 14 and it is coming on the port 1. And then, so this switch, it has to take a decision where it has to send. So it is going to send through the port 3, but it is not sure on which link it has to send. Because multiple links will be available and on which link destination is available, this switch is not having an idea. Because this is what the problem we have faced in the circuit switch. There each switch don't have an idea about the destination. Here also the switch don't have an idea about the destination. So that is why it is decided to send through the port 3, but on which VCI it has to send. That means which link is free, it don't know anything. So that is why it has left that as a blank and it is sent the request to the next available switch, because it will be having an idea about the next switch. It will not be having an idea about the destination. So it will send that request to the next switch. This switch will receive that request on a port 1, whatever the VCI on which link it is coming as a request. So that is coming on the 66th VCI. So then it will receive. Then again it will decide to send it on the second port. But again it don't know on which VCI it should send. So again it will leave blank. Then it will send it to the next available switch, because he don't know the destination. Then he will send it to the next switch. Then he will receive that on the second port with the VCI 22. Then he will decide to send on third port, but he don't know the destination address. Then somehow he will also forward to the next available nodes. Then somehow it will get reached to the destination. Only request has reached the destination. Then the destination will tell that, okay, you have come to the right place. I am the destination. Yes, I am the destination. I am available on a link VCI called as 77. Means this destination is announcing himself that I am the destination and you are in the right path. So my link availability is on VCI number 77. So this is a request phase we call. No, request phase is over. Then how the response will be done? We will see here. No, already till here we have seen. Come back in a reverse fashion. Then you will understand. So till B we have reached the request. No, B has announced that my VCI number is 77. I am available on this VCI. So then he will send it to this particular switch. Then he will think that okay, destination is available at the VCI 77. Then he will update this table, which was left blank here earlier, but at the response, this we call it as acknowledgement phase. This earlier one was called as a request phase. Now we are in the acknowledgement. The destination is giving acknowledgement to the next neighbor switch. Then this switch will update its VCI number. Okay, then he will tell to the next switch that destination is available. Then whatever the switch VCI he will send, so that will be updated here. He is sending. Okay, then destination is available to me, so you can send the data to me. Then he will send the VCI number of himself. then it will get update here. Then this switch will tell to the previous switch, okay, I can reach to the destination somehow. You send me the data. My VCI number is 66. Even he will get update with that. Then the VCI. Then finally it will reach to this. Then he will start sending the data. Once you get all the VCI numbers here, both incoming as well as outgoing, then this data transmission phase will happen. Because without getting those VCI numbers, I explained this. Now assume that this data values, we have got 114, 366, 222, 377. So once you get, that is what the same values are here. This is done by assuming that already setup is done. So now we know how data will get transmitted, because already it know on which port it is coming and which VCI I have to send. Because outgoing VCI is also there, incoming VCI is also there. So it is easy for the switch to decide how the packet should be sent. So that is how the packets will be sent. So this is for sending the packets, because after getting the VCI numbers, it is very easy. But to get the VCI number, first setup, this part we call it as a setup phase. First it has to send a request frame to this switch, then this VCI will be empty. Then once it reaches the destination, destination will respond with the availability of the VCI. Then he will keep on responding with to the previous switches. Then they keep on, these tables will be start filling. Then once we fill all the tables, then the data transmission will start. So this is how the actual switching will happen. Is it clear, students? Any doubts with respect to this? Because first the setup phase has to be done. And once you do the setup phase, VCI numbers of the incoming, actually incoming will be there. But only thing, we need to update the outgoing, because we need the destination address. The outgoing will be empty during the request phase, and that outgoing will be filled during the acknowledgement phase. Once you get these all the three tables filled, then it is easy to transmit the data with the help of incoming VCI and outgoing VCI. That is, getting a VCI number is the most important part. So once you get a VCI, that is nothing but you have established the dedicated path between the source A to the destination P. Once you establish the dedicated path with the help of virtual circuit identifier, then your task is done. You have delivered the data to the destination. So this is that is why it is a combination of both. It is a combination of circuit switch, because we have established a dedicated path. And second one is, we have used packet to get transmit, that is from the datagram. Because circuit switch is used for what? Voice messages. But packet switch is used for data transmission in the form of packets. So we are transmitting the packets with the help of dedicated path. So that is why it is called as combination of circuit switch as well as datagram. From circuit switch, what we have taken? Dedicated path we have taken. From datagram packet, what we have taken? It is used for the packet transmission, because circuit switch was used for only for the voice transmission. So packet datagram was used for the packet transmission. So we have combined both, and we are using this for the data transmission. So while explaining also, first you have to explain setup phase, how the request will be done, then how these VCI tables will be, how the acknowledgement will be received, and then you explain this data transmission phase, how the data will get transmit. Then once you do that, it is done. Is it clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then what
yes,
about
sir.
Okay, now you tell me, what about a delay in this, whether it is going to be same with respect to the datagram or packet switching, which delay is going to be taken? We are going to take a delay from packet switch or datagram network?
Packet switch.
Yes, somewhat it is going to be taken from circuit switch as well as, because whatever the delay, this is a delay of our virtual circuit network. See here, A is sending to this particular switch because it is knowing the VCI of incoming as well as outgoing. So once it comes the data here, it will not wait at this particular switch, because already this switch is reserved for this link only. It is because we said dedicated link is available. Once data reaches to this particular switch, immediately the transmission will start. Only minor amount of delay will be there here. That is for the switching purpose. It will come here and it will start. Then again here, it will be only minor amount of delay. It will come here and it will transmit. We'll just have a look of the previous circuit switch delay, how the diagram was there. Here see, this is a datagram network delay, because here we don't have any dedicated path. So it will come to this switch. Then once it comes to this switch, then decision has to be taken on which switch I have to send.
So for that, there will be a waiting time here. So this waiting time is eliminated here. Then definitely delay is less than the datagram or more than datagram?
Less than datagram,
but more than circuit switch.
Circuit switch.
Yes, it is going to be an intermediate delay between circuit switch as well as datagram. Means some part of the delay is reduced as well from the datagram. Some part of the efficiency is increased from circuit switch. So both, whatever the, our agenda was there, both has been satisfied in this virtual circuit networks. So that is how switching at the data link layer in a switched WAN is normally implemented by using, that is nothing but data link layer, what we have used in our TCP/IP protocol and OSI layer. Both at that particular data link layer, we are going to use virtual circuit network transmission only. Keep this in mind. The VCN is going to happen at the data link layer. Already I said circuit switching is going to happen at the physical layer, and that packet switching is going to happen at the network layer. So this is going to happen at the data link layer. So keep remember these points. So this is in fact in most of the question paper, he targeted virtual circuit networks only. If you have any doubts, you can ask him only. But you need to explain all this diagram. Diagram itself will take you around 10 minutes to draw. That VCI numbers you can take randomly. There is no fixed meaning in this VCI numbers. But make sure whatever the port numbers you put here, the same port number has to be taken. But VCI numbers, you can assume whatever you want, incoming port number and output. Don't take a duplicate VCI numbers. VCI numbers should be unique. Here also he has taken a unique VCI number. Here it is 6614 and here it is 2277 and 6622, like that. A separate VCI numbers, so try to take separate VCI numbers only as much as possible. Don't take duplicate so that it will avoid the complications. So is it clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Then third model, second chapter is also over. Only third chapter is remaining, that is CRC, cyclic redundancy check. So that we will start from next class then. Very important question this. Don't neglect. Study well. So I think already second IA dates also they have announced. Soon you will get a notice. I'll forward. Already I think madam might have forwarded.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then start reading from second model where we had left. Till transmission modes we have kept for the first IA. From there, second model half, and this third model already half is completed. Not hard. If 70% is completed, another 30% is there. From tomorrow, I'll take that. Okay then. Shall I close the class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.